299,792,458 meters a second. That is the speed of light. But can we actually stop it in its tracks? Well, firstly, the speed of light is the cosmic speed limit. Nothing can go faster than it. In fact, you can't even reach it because you're too heavy. Only massless particles like the photons that make up light go at that speed. Except when they don't. You might know that light doesn't always drive around at the speed limit. It does in a vacuum, but when it's traveling through other materials, it tends to go slower. That's the very reason why swimming pools look shallower than they actually are, and how you're enjoying me right now over the reams of fiber optic cables that we like to call the internet. In fact, if you want to know a bit more about how the internet works, check out James May's video here. But even in those cases, light is going pretty damn fast. Recently though, some researchers in Germany have been able to stop light in its tracks for a whole minute. Now, I know a minute doesn't sound like a very long time, but for light, it is. Remember, in that time, it would normally travel the equivalent of 450 times around the Earth. So, how do you put the cooler on light? What you need is a glass-like crystal, two lasers, and some praseodymium ions. Now, those charged particles in the crystal make it opaque, which means light can't get in or out of the crystal. Except when you use your first laser. By firing a beam at the crystal, a quantum effect called electromagnetically induced transparency occurs. Basically, that allows light of a very specific color to get through. Enter laser number two, which just so happens to have light of that very specific color. So it can travel through the crystal. But the trick then is to turn off the first laser, which makes the crystal opaque and traps that light inside the crystal. In fact, the light inside the crystal isn't really light anymore, it's a spin wave. Basically, those praseodymium ions, because they have electrons orbiting around the nucleus, have something called spin, which makes them a bit like a bar magnet. Now, if you wiggle one of those bar magnets, it's going to interact with all the other ones, causing the nearest one to wiggle, and then the one nearest that, and so on. So you get this wave of all these bar magnet-like particles, and that is what our light has turned into. But we can retrieve the original light from the crystal, and that's exactly what the researchers did after that minute. What's even better is that it retains its quantum coherence, which essentially means this could be the new way of storing information. So in the future, this very video could be frozen light trapped inside a crystal, which you could then access at super fast speeds. That's basically Kryptonian technology from Superman.
Because really, the internet, I don't want to spoil the magic here, but it is like a giant telephone network with cables and wireless signals simply connecting people and devices to the internet all over the world.